Okay. Yeah, it's a good morning. It's a good morning. I guess. No, it's a good morning. Nice bullet over here. Gotta remember that. No, today's not Friday. You're seeing this on Friday, but this is Saturday. I'm still on the road. So, both sides bullet. I got Friday morning at 5:30, I got on site to unload. 6:30, 7:30. Oh, they're starting to unload. They told me to be there at 5:30 because they had a crane and wanted to unload me early. 7:30, they started unloading. 8:30, 9:30, 10:30, 11:30. Oh, it's lunchtime. 12:30, 1:30, 2:30, I'm done unloading, 9 hours later. And I had to load by 2 o'clock at the other spot to get my back home. So instead, I head back home empty. I'm still heading home. Back home empty. The roads are wet-ish here. Wherever it's black, it's wet. Where it's white, it is icy. We're catching up with someone. I made some poor decisions.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, oh yeah. Oh, please like and subscribe, yeah, that good, yeah.
So, left Portland, like I got a few hours of drive time, okay? Oh, Highway 14's closed due to an accident. Blocking both lanes. Okay, called the boss. I actually did that live with you guys 2 weeks ago on the bonus video. Because the bonus video is pretty cool 2 weeks ago. Consider hitting that join button for 99 cents a month. Called the boss to see if I can take 84 instead of 14 because there's extra fuel tax on that. Goes, yep, go ahead, get yourself home. Did that, then took 97 to Yakima. Found out that I-90 is closed through the Columbia River Gorge. So, parked it for the night. Got up at 4 in the morning, I'm like, okay, let's look at the... Nope, it's still closed. Go back to bed. Woke up at 5, I'm like, I can't go back to bed, but it's still closed. It's still closed. I'm like, the... Then the warning said, we're going to assess the road conditions in the morning to see when the roads will open. I'm like, well, it's 6 o'clock now. I've waited long enough. I'm going through Tri-Cities. Should have just waited. Because the road opened half an hour ago. And I'm going to hit I-90 up ahead over here about exactly the same time if I just had gone the other way. So I ended up just wasting Sutco's fuel money and my time. Yep, made some poor choices. Sorry. I'll try to do better next time. Just gotta be a little more patient and just wait it out, I guess. No cruise control, no engine brakes on this stuff. And of course, fluid pass is closed, so I can't take that way home. So when I decided to go this way, it was the only way home. But now, I could have taken I-90 through the Columbia Gorge and then go through Dry Falls like towards Soap Lake, like we're doing now. Getting mist on my windshield from that truck in front of us. That's good. I mean, I don't like getting a dirty windshield, but it's good that the roads are misting. It means they've got traction. So, oh yeah, I guess I should say where we are. I'm on Highway 17. Approaching Moses Lake. There might be some other stuff between here and Moses Lake, but we're headed towards Moses Lake. Northbound on 17. That was mile marker 20, I think. Just saw the corner of my eye. Warden. Some kind of research center. I've got no food left in the truck. That's not 100% true, but no good food left in the truck. There's some canned food in here, but I'll get home around 1:30-ish. This is ice. We're on solid black ice now. Probably be later than 1:30 and running on stuff like this. Hopefully the sun hits these roads and makes them all wet and sloppy. I mean, there's not even snow, it's just frost. They're certainly slippery. Yeah, the best call for me would have been, okay, I can't go to sleep, fire up the laptop and play Farming Sim for a bit. Check the conditions every half hour. That's what I should have done. No, I was so eager to get home that I didn't save myself a single minute of time. Maybe even lost a little bit. Altona Farms. only other Altona I knew was in Manitoba, the town of Altona. This is Altona Farm. I wonder if Altona is a last name then. Are we on our brakes? Don't see a signal light. He hit his brakes. More brakes. Is there a car in front of him? There is. Okay. That guy's going really slow. Fair enough. The roads are slippery. Yeah, so yesterday there was no way of getting across the mountains in Washington due to all the road closures. Spin my tires, that's good. Oh, a little bit there. Yep, felt a little bit there. So they're slippery, but not as slippery as I thought they were. Potatoes on the side of the road? It's potatoes! Somebody lost a whole bunch of potatoes. Just scattered all over the highway here. I wonder what happened there. Still, potatoes all the way along here. More taters. Less taters here, but they're still taters. Man, how many hundreds, thousands of meals are laying in the ditch? heck am I next right? Nope, that... Well, that road might actually be open. Wait, could I have taken that road? Dang it, that's probably another poor decision. I could have probably taken that road instead of going through Tri-Cities. Oh. Yeah. You know what? I'm definitely not functioning at 100%. I'm making poor choices. Yeah, I could have come in here from Yakima. Done that instead. I don't know if it would have saved any time, but it would save miles. Blame my customer. I had to get up at 4 in the morning to deliver early there. And then they didn't start unloading until 7:30, so I had just come like a normal time and gotten my normal sleep. Maybe I wouldn't have made all these dumb decisions. Truck stop here. Moses Lake is another 24 miles, so we're still away from Moses Lake. Slow traffic. Here I'm like, I'll be able to go a little quicker. No. It's not the type of day this is gonna be. So, I've already committed to working on Monday, so it's gonna be a one-day weekend. A couple of drivers on vacation, so I think I'll request a day off next week. Maybe. We'll see. Traffic in front of me is not that slow. It's taking me a while to catch up. Yeah, I mean, not the full speed limit, but... Roads are actually getting a little dryish here. Some good news! It's one of those portable way stations anyway, I think. I mean, it might be built into the ground. Let's see. No, it's just a big concrete paved pad. No, I don't see any scale built into the ground, so it would be a portable scale. See where it's shinier. I think the road's wet there, but for the most part it's dry here. The actual tracks anyway are dry. It's nice. Hopefully we keep this all the way up now. Get home. Although they just said we got a lot of snow at home, so if there'd even be space for me to park somewhere. Stopped on the road. See a lot of hay stacks sitting in the fields. all beehives. All those sheds there, I think they're all beehives. Nope. Very wrong. Nope. They are a shelter for calves. Looks like these guys have all been wrangled in. Not sure if they're ready for transport. Why are we slowing down? Signal lights are not working. That's the issue there. Oh, they're working on the side of the truck. They're not working on the back of the truck. So it was signaling, but light's not working. Use cruise control, but then it looks like there's still some Chinese sections. Nah, we won't. Let's not risk it. Potholes. Apparently potholes to the left. Yes, left. Rethink that one. Long straight road right into Moses Lake, it looks like. Let's turn the brakes on just here for a little bit. Hey guys, if you guys want to ask me any questions in live, real time, join us on the weekend. We've kind of changed how we do our other channel. Jess is now doing live streams during the week, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, at about 3:30 Mountain Time. I know that does not work for some of you guys on the other side of the world. Jess is doing some streams. We're kind of testing it out. She's just playing some games. Feel free to suggest some other games for her to play. If it's something that she would enjoy, maybe she would do it. She loves the strategy simulator games. Zoo Tycoon, Roller Coaster, Farming Sim, and stuff like that. Just like me. I know she could probably make a whole bunch of money if she played first-person shooter, got a green screen, and but we're just not into that, so nothing wrong with that. I have no problem with people playing that. If that's what you enjoy, play what you enjoy, but we're into sim. So Jess had her own channel, I had my own channel for gaming, and it's like, why are we working on our own channels when I'm the one streaming on the weekends and she's the one streaming during the week? So why don't we combine the two channels into one and do that? So that's what we've done. So come on in on the weekends, watch me live stream, and during the week go watch Jess live stream and ask her anything. And she'll at least stream live stream during the week until she can come with again, and then she'll be in the truck with us, which would be better, much better. We'll see if they relax the law again. They did just before Christmas. They relaxed the law enough. It's like, hey, Jess can leave and come with. We're getting ready. It's like, okay, this is the week we're gonna do it. And that's when I went to Texas. It's like, nope, it doesn't work. But we'll see if after the holidays everything will kind of calm down, maybe in February. I don't know. I'm hopeful. But in the meantime, come and ask us anything. This Saturday, I can't say this Saturday because this Saturday was 2 weeks ago for you guys. Thinking I'm gonna get home, I'm gonna eat some food, take a nice bath, and do some kind of live stream. Who are we kidding? I'll be playing Farming Sim, right? It's my go-to game. Love it. For a couple of reasons. I would play some other games a lot more often, like Project Zomboid. Play that game a lot more often. Trucking Sim, Flight Simulator. All of those games are so much harder to carry on a conversation with you guys than Farming Sim, because Farming Sim is a little bit of a simpler game. The GPS mod on, I have time to read comments and reply to them, so it's one of the big reasons I play that game. Love the game, and I can talk to you guys, and the whole point of doing a live stream is so I can talk to you guys. Below in the description to that channel. If not, poke me a comment. Leave me a comment. Where was the poke me thing? Was that like, send a poke? Was that like a messenger thing or man, there's something, some kind of social media thing many years ago. Could send pokes. But yeah, drop down a comment. Also, man, it's cool that you guys joined me. Hey, look, I-90. We would have been here. We would have been here earlier if I had just waited it out. Yeah, I'm pretty confident on that one. Darn it. Oh well. I don't like it when I screw up. I gotta learn to move on when I screw up. I'm not very good at that. Moses Lake, Ephrata, straight ahead. We're not gonna go through Ephrata. We're gonna kind of bypass Ephrata, but we're headed that way. And Moses Lake, this is Moses Lake right here. It's mostly to the left, west of this highway, but I bet your Moses Lake has one of those beautiful old downtowns. Never gone, so I don't know. Ephrata, 21 miles away. Like Moses Lake has grown further out east than the last time I came through here. I don't want to stop. I have engine brakes on the lowest setting. have some good fences and cameras around them. I bet you they grow pot in them. See, there's all these fields with these big fences around them and cameras, and most of them are just empty and nothing ever happened to them. When they legalized marijuana, everybody wanted to build, grow, and there was this mad gold rush, and most people failed. Even some of the really big, where they spend millions of dollars on factories, like on these big, not I guess factories, but huge greenhouses, a lot of those failed too, so it wasn't the boom everybody expected it to be. Legalized it, everybody's gonna smoke it now. No. The same people that smoked it before are still smoking it. Nobody extra went out and smoked it. Now you just don't go to jail for it. Nothing changed. Everybody's like, you can't legalize that. You're smoking that stuff everywhere. No, nothing changed. Nothing changed. Just less people in jail. Definitely more snow this way. Looks like we're into the older parts of the city. Not like the old parts, more the trailer home part of town. Wait, should I have turned off there? No? Am I good? That would be towards the airport. Yeah, the GPS is going the right way. Okay. Like, I should double check that. Don't need to blindly be following a GPS. Practice what I preach, right? That's a beautiful viewpoint down into the valley. Big Bend Community College. That's the airport right here beside us to the right. Can't see anything, but that's where the airport is. There's some big jets parked there. Look, another pullout over here. Just north of Moses Lake. Gotta remember that one. Power line poles are all made out of glue lamp. Interesting. Glue lamp power poles. Basically, they're just like, I guess it'd be like 2x10s or whatever they're using, lumber glued together. Funny, lots of snow here and the roads are dry. Back there, no snow and the roads were slippery. Country up here though. Wide open, part of the Columbia Basin. Lava flows, Columbia lava flows. Google Columbia lava flows, you'll find some great talks on these. Can't remember his name, but there's professor that geologist that has some really good talks online about all the lava flows and how Columbia River used to travel the old way Columbia River flowed. And it's pretty cool. Suggested him. I watched his videos for many, many years. said, I think it's his last name. Nick. Yeah, if you want to learn anything about the Columbia River, Columbia Basin, Columbia Basalt, Columbia River, he's got some awesome videos. And it's kind of hard to find where his videos are. They're posted on different YouTube channels. Columbia Lava Flow, you'll find videos by Nick. Nick said something. Freda is left. We're not going left. We're going to Grand Coulee Dam. No, we're not. Drive through that canyon so often. Dry Falls. I've shot lots of video through there, so I figured I'd shoot a little earlier and drive, show you guys roads I don't take so often. Honestly, I would have preferred not to take these roads, but. I'll call it a day of. Well, it's an hour already, right? Well, you know what, let's drive through Soap Lake and then I'll call it a day, so maybe I'll cover a little bit longer video. You know what, maybe I'll just say goodbye to you guys now, it's been an hour, and then I'll let the video play a little bit longer. I'll get rid of the shoulder cam and you can just enjoy the scenery for another few minutes. All these huge rocks around here, those are all like big lava rocks that have been pushed over here and dropped by glaciers. My understanding anyway. Ask a real geologist to get a real answer. But you see these huge rocks everywhere. And they're not all lava rocks. They're different kinds of rocks. You see rocks that don't belong here placed in there as well. And it must have moved all down here from Canada. The glaciers. It's pretty cool. Anyway, huge thank you to you guys that hit that join button. You'll see your name at the end over here. Also, if your name's not in the end over there, thank you as well for being here and watching this and having someone for me to talk to. I see there's always like 500 to 600 of you guys that watch this video. Mind blowing for me that so many of you guys watch this video every day. Thank you. I am out of here. You guys enjoy your weekend. Mine will be a short one, but I'm going to try to enjoy it anyway. I am out of here. You guys rock.
This video is brought to you in part by the letter C and these YouTube members. Cookie starts with C. What other things start with C? Oh, who cares what other things? C is for Cookie, and that's good enough for me. Thanks for watching. I'm done.